Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. Today in conversion rate optimization, we'll discuss about how and what to test. Testing plays a very important, crucial and critical role in the design, development of any application, any website, any software, any product that you want to put out there in the market. You are doing it for yourself, or you are doing a self-development, it's your own product, or you are doing it for the customers. Because the testing at the end of the day matters a lot. You have to deliver a software, an application that is completely tested, error-free and bug-free. And what actually you need to test and how you need to test is something that we'll check out today. What are the different parts that you need to check? One is the user interface, that which actually appears on the screen. That is the user interface. And user interface is what actually the user, the visitor actually checks. And that need to be tested thoroughly and extensively. Then you have user experience. User experience is laid a lot of emphasis on that. The user experience matters at the end of the day a lot. The better the user experience, the user friendliness is there, the user experiences application completely good and is happy with it. User experience plays a very important role in interacting with the users on a website or an application. Completely tested, thoroughly tested user experience is extremely important. Usability factors plays a very important role in thoroughly ensuring that your application, your software is available on top of the pages, and make sure that you know the usability test is done completely and thoroughly. Then you have functionality. Every software, every application that is out there in the market, they have functionality. The functionality is at the core business logic of an application, and the functionality has to be thoroughly and completely checked. Then you have the database, the back end part of it, and that database is actually thoroughly checked. And these are actually different parts of an application that need to be tested across the platforms. Now, what is actually the levels of testing that need to be done? The first level is called the unit test. A unit test is basically testing individual components. When you have a software, there are individual components to it, and each component is actually designed and developed separately. It could be a user interface, it could be a functionality, it could be a database. These three are the different parts, and within the functionality, there could be different components. Within, like, a registration page is different, acceptance page is different, the backend is different. There are different functionality pages within the functionality, different components, and within the user interface there could be different components. The same goes with the database, and each component is separately tested, and that is called as the unit test. Then happens the integration test, that is test component groups. The integration happens when these different elements of the user interface is integrated together, the functionality, different components of the functionality is integrated together, then you have the database that is integrated together. And when the integration happens, you actually group the components and put together and test it. Then finally, the system test, the test the integrated system. Whatever the system that you integrated here is actually tested here, that is actually the complete system, wherein the user interface, the business logic, the functionality and database are integrated together, and that becomes the system test. Then finally you have the acceptance test. This is actually the product that you are about to deliver to the customer. That is the final acceptance test, that is the user side, from the user's point of view. And these are the different levels of testing that need to be carried out thoroughly and extensively. And how actually you can build a test? The first phase is mapping the application, wherein the business logic, which is the functionality part of it, application flow, application surface and application entry points. This is the first phase, which where you are mapping the requirements along with the application to be built. Then you have the phase two, which are the tools based testing. As we discussed, there are two types of testing that can be done. One is called the manual testing, the second is called the automation testing. Here you are actually doing the tools based testing, and these are the different types of tools that can be tested and reports are generated. The third is actually the manual part of it. And any application, completely robust, scalable and that performs well, has to be tested in both ways. You do it automated part of it and you do it the manual way of it. And both the techniques have to be used to ensure that the application, the software that you are building, where you need high end of conversions, where the customers expects lot of conversions to happen, then the testing has to be in both ways, the manual way and the automated way. And finally, you have the correlation analysis, which is actually the entire process wherein happened, and make sure that you know the correlation is done, which is the final acceptance part of the application. In conclusion, what we have seen in this video is what to test, levels of testing, and how to test the different phases of it. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you again.